we've seen a vast improvement in the property market in Cork over the last 6 months especially. If we compare quarter one with quarter two, we've seen that there's a 32% increase in property transactions, closed property transactions in this time period. The big contribution to that, of course, is that lending institutions are now back with force. They are lending to first-time buyers especially, and they're very active at the moment, along with investors in the Cork property market.
We've seen a big uplift in the Galway property market in the last 12 months, probably 15 to 20% of an increase in residential property going across the board, mainly driven on by owner-occupiers who are now back in the market. Banks are lending, the finance is available for them. Back to old school lending where they have to have 90% of mortgages and be able to come up with a deposit themselves. And then you have the investors who have now realised that, you know what, there's no value now in the banks, leaving money on deposit. There's no value in bonds. They're now saying the value is in bricks and mortar, and that they're looking for a capital uplift on what they can and what they're buying, and they see that maybe over the next 7 to 10 years.
Over the last 20 years, there's been huge infrastructural changes. There's been the development of the Ring Road, dual carriageway linking both north and south side of the city. There's been the development of the Jack Lynch Tunnel, which allows for easy access to Dublin, Limerick, Kerry and Waterford. There's a proposed redevelopment of the Cork Harbour area as well. This will ensure Cork City's prominence as a leading city in Europe.
Well, we've seen the advent of the motorway coming from Dublin now. It's complete. It's a 2-hour trip, round trip from Galway to Dublin. That gives easy access to the west of Ireland. Then you have the college, the NUIG, which is the main university. Both universities, the NUIG and the GMIT, are both expanding at an extraordinary rate. So there's more and more students coming to town, more and more accommodation is needed. And then also in the spin-off of that, you have those graduates leaving. They're going into multinationals, which are all based around Galway. They're hiring all the time. So signs on that things are picking up in Galway all the time.
A particular focus on any properties that are located near the city centre, any properties that would be just north of the river, south side of the river, and particular smaller units. Small houses offer very good value in the Blackpool area, for example, at the moment, and also city centre apartments offer very good value as well, and they're hugely in demand. People do want to be located near to the city centre to go to work. Another location I'd consider as well would be the Citygate Business District. An area surrounding that would be in Glenmire, maybe near the Jacobs Island apartment complex as well, as there's huge demand in that particular area. There's some of the world's largest companies have located to the Citygate Business District, companies, leading companies in pharmaceuticals, healthcare, IT and financial services. And it's still possible to pick up a 2-bedroom apartment in that area for about €150,000. The demand is exceptional for rental units in that area at the moment, and they're renting out for between €900 and €950 per month, and they're let within a 24-hour period.
Well, I'd encourage anyone to buy in Galway for the simple reason that we have two universities in Galway. We have NUIG and the GMIT with over 25,000 students in and around the Galway city area, not to mention all the multinationals out there. Buying properties for investment, there's never an issue in relation to renting. Rentals are, the demand for them is huge at the moment. We have seriously problems with stock. And while you might get huge rental yields out of it, we do see a capital appreciation growth maybe over the next 4 to 5 years in the region of 40, maybe 50% in some cases.